והוא אחד ואין שני, להמשילו, להחבירה, בלי ראשית, עוד בלי תכלית, ולא העוז והמשרה.
In פרשת אמור, we can find something very interesting that relate basically to the old framework of Sefer Vayikra. Basically, Sefer Vayikra, we can say in a very general way that we can divide Sefer Vayikra to two parts. The first part, since the beginning of the Sefer until the middle of Parashat Achrei Mot, is basically about things that relate to Kohanim, Korbanot, Tum'ah, Tahara, Uva Kohen, Vayikriv Kohen, Vera Kohen, Vizgir Kohen, all the things that are very, very strong connection to Kehuna. The second part of Sefer Vayikra basically speaking about Kedusha, that relate to the old Jewish people, Kedoshim Tiyu Ki Kadosh Ani Hashem Elohechem, and relate about Parashat, and speaks about Parashat Arayot, and about relations between man and his fellow man, and about between Ben Adam Lamakom, Ben Adam Lachavera, all the idea of Kedusha, of sanctity, of holiness, that relate to all of Israel. But basically there are two exceptions to this division. In the first part, we have Parashat Shmini, the Ma'achalot Asurot, the animals that we are not allowed to eat, that basically relate to all the Jewish people, not specifically about the Kohanim. This is the one, Yotze Min HaKlal exception. And the second one in Parashat Emor. The first part of Parashat Emor is basically speak just about the Kohanim, Emor El HaKohanim B'nei Aaron, L'Nefesh Lo Itama Be'amav, all the Halachot about the Kohanim. But the question is, why? If the division is quite organized to the two parts, why we have these two exceptions? So, to say it in a very short way, I would like to say that maybe the idea is that Torah wants to tell us something very interesting about what does it mean, kehuna, and what is the idea that we, as Am Yisrael, we supposed to be Mamlechet Kohanim V'Goy Kadosh. Mamlechet Kohanim V'Goy Kadosh is not Mamlecha, is not a Medina, a state that we have Kohanim, but that all of us, we in a way, a kind of Kohanim, all Am Yisrael. And it's not a dichotomy between being Kohen or being Israel. It's basically there is a line that you can see that in a way, all of us are Kohanim. We are Mamlechet Kohanim, and therefore we are not allowed to eat these kinds of impure animals, Behemot Tmeot. On the other side, as the second part, the Torah wants to teach us about the Kohanim, to tell us that the Kohanim are not detached from Am Yisrael. Their Kedusha, their sanctity, basically emerge from the Kedusha of Am Yisrael. It's one system, Kohanim and Israel, and therefore, although we have this kind of division between Dinei Kehuna and Dinei Kedusha, the Torah wants to teach us that we, all of us, we are Mamlechet Kohanim V'Goy Kadosh, and therefore we have some dinim of Kohanim in the of Kedusha in the first part, to tell us that we, all of us, we are Kohanim and we are Kedoshim. At the same time, we have in the second part this specific halachot about Kohanim to tell us that the Kedusha of the Kohanim basically come and emerge from the Kedusha of all of Israel. The idea that the Kohen shouldn't be in touch with Tum'ah, with impure things, the idea of because the Tum'ah basically connected to Mavet, to death. The Torah is Torah Chaim, and the Tum'ah in our approach is something that basically connected to Mavet, and we have to remember that all of us basically we have to deal and to find the main challenge of the Torah in the real life. תורה היא תורת חיים, אשר יעשה אותם האדם וחי בהם.